Bronston Jones! Bronston Jones! How are we doing, guys? Good? How's your night? Yeah. Nice city. Nice. I'm going to put this here. Don't Cosby, all right? I like those you laughed at that joke. If you did not laugh at that joke, have you been asleep for the last 5 years? Which means, do you actually know Bill Cosby? Way too creepy of a laugh at that, dude. Cover your drinks, man. All right, so I'm visiting here. I'm from California. Couple people, yeah, it's fucking awesome. Here's the best thing about California, not the ocean, it's this, is now in California, we have legal marijuana. Some people, you just looked at me like, fuck, I gotta go to California. Illegal weed there, you gotta be 21, you can go to a pot shop, you can buy whatever you want, right? And I was saying, I think it's awesome for a couple reasons. One is I think it helps our society and our criminal justice system that a lot of people with marijuana convictions can now have those absolved. And it's just a great thing for society. And I was explaining that to my buddy. I'm like, dude, isn't it amazing we have legal weed? He's like, no. No, it's not. I'm like, why? He goes, the United States of America already has enough problems with alcohol. We don't need to add the problems of weed. He's never been high in his life. So I had to explain to him that the solution to 90% of the problems with alcohol is weed. All right, you guys aren't on board yet. Let's get into it. He's never been high, so he thinks getting drunk and getting high are the same thing, right? There's some similarities, but they're very different, different beasts, right? Here's the biggest one. I think this is the biggest difference is this, is when you are drunk, you don't think anybody knows you're drunk, do you? How many times have you been sitting there a couple cocktails in with your buddy and you're just pontificating about your political views? And your buddy's like, dude, keep it down. It sounds like you might get racist in a second. Seriously, you're getting loud, you're drunk. And your response is, I'm not even drunk yet. I'll tell you what's drunk is this floor because it's not standing still. So when you're drunk, you don't think anybody knows you're drunk, but when you're high, you think everybody knows you're high, don't you? You just walk around like... It's crazy. People do stupid, stupid stuff when they're drunk. Stupid stuff. My buddy, he's one of those angry drunks. He likes to fight people and stuff, right? He was so hammered one night, he went to swing at this guy. Because he was drunk, he missed that guy, hit the cop in the face right behind him. Yeah, stupid stuff when people drink. I'll tell you this, when you're high, you're not punching anybody. Because when you're high, you think everybody's a fucking cop. The most stupid thing I've ever done in my entire life. This is the dumbest thing I've ever done in my life, and I've got STDs. Everybody has them that I've been with. So, don't improv lines like that, Bron. Stop improving. Stupidest thing I ever did in my life, right? It was my 40th birthday, and I was visiting a buddy of mine, a kid, you know, that I knew as a child, and he's big into water skiing and wakeboarding. I've never done that before, so we went out on his speedboat, his ski boat, right? It's my 40th birthday. I said, you know what we should do, dude? Let's knock this thing up to 40 knots. And he goes, why? And I say, because I'm going to jump off the boat. 40 knots, just so you know, is 46 miles per hour. When I hit the water, my neck went... I thought I was paralyzed forever. But really, it only turned out that my one knee got so jacked that I had a limp for a year. Why did I do it? Because I was drunk and Florida. If you want to see it, look up my name on YouTube. Bronston Jones, stupidest thing I've ever done in my life. It is up there. How do I have it on video? Because my little brother was on the boat. And he said, oh, really? You're going to jump off this thing? Let's fucking film it. He hoped that I was going to die. Stupid, stupid stuff. I'll tell you the scariest thing I ever did when I was high. I ate an edible once, and I went into IKEA. Holy shit. For those of you who are not big into the weed, let me explain this. is when you are smoking pot, right? When you smoke, it takes maybe a minute, 2 minutes to get into your bloodstream. You start feeling the buzz, you start feeling the high, right? So you can figure out exactly how high you're gonna get, and you know immediately, so you know, like, hey, pass it on, we're done. When you do an edible, that edible will decide when it's gonna hit you, which is anywhere between 30 minutes and 1 hour is when it gets to your liver and your bloodstream. It will decide when it's gonna hit you, and it's also gonna decide how fucking hard it's gonna hit you. And I did this thing, is my body, if you've ever eaten edibles, is a kind of cook a wheat cookie. And he goes, this wheat cookie's really strong, man. Don't eat it all at once. He gave me the warning. And because I made this mistake, I did not eat it all at once. I took his advice. What did I do? I broke the cookie into quarters. And I ate the first quarter of the cookie, set my watch. Oh my God. Somewhere between 30 and 60 minutes, I'm gonna feel this strong cookie. And what happened? An hour and 10 minutes went by. And I was like, my buddy's a lying piece of shit. So what did I do? Ate the rest of the goddamn cookie. And everybody who's done edibles has done this. And what happens is that first quarter of the cookie that's down here dissolving, getting ready to get in your liver and stuff, sees the other three quarters of the cookie crumbles come down, and goes, let's kick in this party now! Shit right now. According to my recent research, in an hour and 10 minutes, I'm gonna be four times as high. And this fucking kitchen that I just moved into in IKEA is beautiful. This apartment is massive. How the fuck do I afford this? I love the Husker Du. Open up the cabinets, I'm like, I need to get some groceries, man. I got munchies, this is bullshit. And I like sativas. I like sativas as the head high. Sativas is the kind of thing that makes you go say just really crazy stuff like, is your puppy's name Purple? Because I can see its aura. This apparently had a lot of indica in it. Indica is the body low. And I was like, I need to take a nap. So I chose one of my new bedrooms at IKEA. I picked the one with a bunk bed because I never had a bunk bed. I've always wanted a bunk bed. And I climbed to the top bunk, took a nap. How long was I asleep? I don't know. However long it takes for security to realize some dude's taking a nap. And tell that dude he needs to leave the IKEA. And I was like, sir, I would gladly leave this IKEA. But there's no way I'm finding my way out of this place right now. It's not gonna happen. You're gonna have to Sherpa me down to those meatballs. It's crazy. One last fact, and then I'll get out of here for you guys, is alcohol. According to the Center for Disease Control, the CDC, 88,000 Americans every single year die from issues related to alcohol. A lot of it's cirrhosis of the liver, et cetera, et cetera. About 10,000 people a year actually drink themselves to death. Alcohol poisoning, they die. They OD, overdose on alcohol. Do you guys know how many people per year overdose on marijuana? Zero. It's not possible to do it for two reasons. One, if it's a sativa, you start saying that stupid shit, and your friend's like, I think you're done. And they leave with it. Or if it's the indica, you decide you're gonna take a nap for 4 to 5 days. But here's the deal, now that we have edibles, now that you can put marijuana, you can put THC into any goddamn thing you wanna eat, there's chicken wing hot sauce with marijuana, and how fucking stoned was that person when he came up with that? Like, I got the munchies, I need these chicken wings. I need more chicken wings because I keep getting the munchies. But here's the truth. You can now get chocolate chip cookies with marijuana and peanuts in them. And one of these Darwin disaster peanut fucks
is gonna finally die from marijuana and ruin that statistic forever. Fuck your peanut allergies. Get high. Thank you guys, you're the best New York City alive.